The first edition of the ŠKODA Prize was really tremendously successful. And in the second year, we have a whole range of new developments. For example, apart from the ₹1 million first prize, we now offer Swiss residencies, courtesy of Pro Helvetia, to the two runners-up. And so these developments, along with outreach programs that we've conducted and workshops that we've conducted, really enhance our primary purpose, which is to bring to public notice the range and strength and innovativeness of Indian contemporary art. The three artists on our shortlist all deal with the past, but they deal with it in different ways. Ellen Tallur was trained in museology, and so traditional artifacts are a kind of preoccupation for him. A lot of his artworks play off what one might see in a museum, and they do so with a tremendous sense of humor. In the show Chromatophobia, which was shortlisted for the ŠKODA Prize, he takes this kind of playfulness to a new level, kind of merging it with a profound and complex view of the way we think about our past and the way we respond to artifacts in museums.
Lakshmi is considered chanchala, the restless and the whimsical one, who does not like to stay at the place. Chromatophobia is defined as an abnormal and persistent fear of money. I think India has very strong tradition of chromatophobia. There is a tradition of nailing a coin at the entrance of the doorstep and the back doorstep. This clarifies me that even in our tradition there is a kind of tradition of chromatophobia and a kind of a therapy within our system. So I thought, I developed the therapy part. So I think I have taken this bark, and then I asked people to kind of nail or hammer a coin. And your coin, when you are nailing, coin remains there. It doesn't go anywhere. You're very confident. You are not losing your money. This elephant actually come from Elephanta. The history is a British officer wanted this elephant to take it to the England. The crane broke and the elephant broke into pieces. The whole sculpture is actually broken into many pieces. People can rejoin this thing. And I call it a fifth dimension. When you are uncomfortable with commercial sculptures which we have, you can remake the sculpture with the enlightenment machine. You can use this machine to grind them and you can give your shape. So it's something similar with the 0+0 also. Whether you feel you are not so good, so then you grind yourself. So you construct yourself. You sculpt yourself. So this is kind of, it's a construction as well as deconstruction.
Jitish Kallat responds in his art to the sights that he sees on the streets of Bombay. It could be a large billboard, or it could be a Victorian Gothic facade, or it might be a riot that he saw or heard about. He has brought all of these visions of the street into the museum in his show Field Notes, which was shortlisted for the ŠKODA Prize.
With Field Notes, Tomorrow Was Here Yesterday, which is a show that happened at the Bhavdajilad Museum.
They started going back to the museum's history. In some ways, going back to this image of the scaffolding, which became the sort of resounding image if you look at the museum's recent history. But also the image of the scaffolding became an image that I was anyway obsessed by for a year before that, is this omnipresent image of change, you know, all around us. This bamboo that holds the script of change when a structure goes up or down, it sort of temporarily emerges as a grid. And to me, that grid became a sort of scribal surface, a surface on which I could write something else. That text became the text of these protruding forms, which came from the porch of the Victoria Terminus building. So that's the journey of how things began.
You know, what really fascinates me are the sort of broad themes of art and life, you know, time, death, mortality. These themes find themselves pinned up, so to speak, on the surfaces of walls, on the bulge of a pocket. And I think it's essentially from this space of the neighborhood, from the street, that these themes arrive into one system and hence find their way into one's work.
When the Bhavdaji Lad Museum reopened, it was almost like a flash of looking at these cabinet of communities, which were all sort of, you know, small figurines. And the kind of the grid-like way in which they were displayed suddenly animated this small little archive of images in my head, and which is how I began making these sculptures scaled to those miniature, this Lilliputian world of human folly. You know, the act of making work is often quite similar to publishing a doubt, and in some ways dispersing your uncertainties about life. You know, it's things that you don't know or don't fully grasp that in some ways becomes the starting point to make a piece of work.
Navin Thomas deals with technology, but technology that is obsolete. And because it has lost its utilitarian value, it then becomes interesting for its form and for its history.
I think you can tell a lot about a culture from what it throws away. My favorite pastime is to go to scrap markets and flea markets and see what a city sort of throws away. In this piece, what's going on is that there's a PA speaker serenading a giant ultraviolet bulb, and the bulb is attracting large butterflies in the night, and one of the sound pieces that's playing in the background is of frogs fornicating in the monsoon. I made a large composition piece where I was playing radio frequencies to the catfish. Apart from electronic junk, I also look for objects that have a audio capacity, and I like constructing toys out of it.
Something like the ŠKODA Prize, to my mind, is really about a conversation.
I'm thankful that my work is getting the attention that it deserves.
I think ŠKODA is really doing a good job. It's a kind of, they are creating a win-win situation.